Hello friends, welcome back to the video lecture series of Commerce Zone Bikaner. I am Azad Purohit and today we would be discussing one of the topics from class 12 chapter is Fundamentals of Partnership. The topic would be Guarantee of Profits. Before understanding this, first let's understand what guarantee means. Guarantee means an assurance. In relation to partnership, assurance means wherein one partner is given certain assurance that his share in the profits for a given year would not be less than this minimum amount. So we need to understand how the accounting for the guarantee of profits is to be done in case of partnership. Again, this topic is very important when it comes to the first chapter, as this question is often asked in the board examinations. So let's start this topic. We need to understand that guarantee, the questions related to guarantee can be of four types. The first one would be the plain guarantee case wherein the guarantee is given by all the partners. In other words, we can say that the guarantee is given by the firm. Say for example, A, B and C are partners sharing profits equally. Partner C is guaranteed that his share in the profits for the year will not be less than 20,000 rupees per annum. So here nothing is mentioned, so this would be a guarantee to that partner from all the remaining partners or the guarantee from the firm. Second case would be the guarantee by a selected or a few partners. It can be 1, 2 or 3. It's not by everyone, and also the ratio of the sacrifice to be made in case of deficiency would be given to you, or else the profit sharing ratio would be considered. And in case of the guarantee which is not given by everyone, the partner who has assured his capital account would be reduced, or his share of profits would be reduced to that extent. Third one would be the guarantee which is given by the partner to the partnership firm. What happens here is the partner agrees to contribute to the profits of the firm to a certain extent. That would be the third type of questions when it comes to guarantee. And the fourth and the last type of guarantee would be simultaneous guarantee, wherein the firm gives guarantee to the partner, also one of the partners gives the guarantee to the firm towards the contribution in the total profits of the partnership firm. So that would be the fourth case of the questions. So starting with the first case, wherein the guarantee is given by all the partners, this is the simplest form and it is the easiest also. Easiest in the sense that what you need to do is you need to find out the profit share first. Then you need to see if there is any deficiency. If the amount is exceeding the guaranteed amount, it's well and good. Say for example, if partner A has been given a guarantee that his share in profits would not be less than 10,000. And while calculating the profit in the normal profit sharing manner, if his share in profit comes to anything more than 10,000, then this clause does not apply. So what we would be doing is, if the minimum guaranteed amount has been given to you and then the profit sharing ratio according to the normal procedure, if it is more than the minimum guarantee, then the partner would be entitled to get a more amount. In case of deficiency, what we would be doing is the deficiency would be contributed by all the remaining partners in their profit sharing ratio. Nothing is mentioned to us in the question. And a specific profit sharing ratio is given to you wherein the deficiency has to be contributed in some different manner. Then we will be calculating the deficiency according to the manner which is given to us in the question. Let's look at an example wherein the guarantee is given by all the partners. So please have a look at the example which is on your screen, which says A, B and C are equal partners, wherein C was given a minimum guarantee of 10,000 rupees, the profit for the year ended was 15,000 rupees. So how to calculate this? First, what we have done is, first we have distributed the profit in the normal manner. So the profit sharing ratio being equal, every partner is entitled to get a share of 5,000 each from the total profits. Now the amount of deficiency To partner C who has been given a minimum guarantee of 10,000, the deficiency comes to 5,000. Now this deficiency would be shared by the remaining partners, which means A and B in the profit sharing ratio, which is equal here. So what we will be doing is, in the next step, we will be deducting that 5,000 rupees from the partners A and B in the profit sharing ratio, which comes to 2,500 each. So in the end, we will see that the total share in the profits to partner A would be 2,500 instead of 5,000. To partner B, again it would be 2,500 instead of 5,000. And partner C would be getting 10,000 rupees. The actual share of profit for him would be 5,000, but since minimum guarantee has been given to him, that his share in profits will not be less than 10,000 rupees. So accordingly, if we see, the share of partner C would be 10,000 here. Hope this is clear to you. Coming to the next situation, wherein the guarantee is given by selected partners, it's not by everyone. So the example here on your screen is ABC are equal partners. B guaranteed that the minimum share of profit to C shall not be less than 10,000. Herein the guarantee has not been given by the firm, it is given only by B, which means A's share should not be affected. And then again it says that the profit for the year was 15,000. So what we will be doing, again what we have done in the last question, we will be repeating the same thing. We will be distributing the profit of 15,000 equally, since the profit sharing ratio given to us is equal. Now the share of C comes to 5,000 and B has guaranteed that his share in the profits will not be less than 10,000. So whatever the deficit is, that deficit will be made good by B only. So what we will be doing is, we will be taking 5,000 rupees from B's share in the profits. And accordingly, if you see the final numbers that are here, wherein it says that the share of profits to Mr. A will be 5,000 rupees. B was getting earlier 5,000, but due to this guarantee clause, he has to forego his 5,000 rupees share in favor of C. C would be getting 10,000 as he was guaranteed, which was minimum share for C. So this is how we will be solving the questions. When the guarantee is not given by all the partners, it is given by the selected partners. Then coming to the next situation, wherein the guarantee is given by the partner to the partnership firm. What happens here is, say for example, there are some partners who are doing a partnership firm, and few partners have given a guarantee saying that this much of amount would be contributed from my side towards the total profit of the business. And if that does not happen, what we have to do is, we will take that much share from the partner. We will be taking the deficiency amount. Say for example, if B has promised to contribute 15,000 towards the profits, and in any given year his contribution was only to the extent of 10,000. So what we will be doing is, we will be taking 5,000 rupees from B and we will be adding that to the current year's profit of this partnership firm. After adding this, increased profit could be distributed to all the partners in their normal profit sharing ratio. So what we will be doing here is, we will be taking some amount from partner. We would be adding that to the partnership firm's profits, and this increased profit would be distributed among all the partners in their agreed profit sharing ratio. Then coming to the next illustration of this example, which is there on your screen, it says A, B, C are equal partners. A has guaranteed here that his share of the profits will not be less than 7,000 rupees. He said that he would be contributing at least 7,000 in that given year. And suppose if he could contribute only 4,000, which means there is a deficiency of 3,000 rupees from his side. What we will be doing, we will be taking 3,000 from A and we would be adding that to the profits of the partnership firm. So here, and the profit for the year was 15,000 rupees. So how to solve this? To 15,000 which has been earned by all the partners, we would be adding that deficiency on part of A. So we will be taking 3,000 rupees from A, we would be adding that to 15,000, making the total to 18,000. Now this 18,000 would be distributed to all the partners in their agreed profit sharing ratio, which is equal In other words, every partner would be getting 6,000 each. So the net impact on A would be 6,000 he would be getting and 3,000 he has to pay, which means a net increase of 3,000 would be there in case of the capital account of A here. Is this clear? This is the guarantee which has been given by the partnership firm to the partner to the partnership firm. Then there would be a simultaneous guarantee wherein the guarantee has been given by the firm to one of the partners, and also one of the partners, not the one who has received this guarantee, also the other partner has given some guarantee. So what we will be doing is, first we will be seeing if any partner who has contributed less than what he has promised, we will be taking that portion from his share, and then we will be adding up to that profit. Then we will do the calculation in the normal process, and if there is any deficiency with regard to the amount guaranteed to one of the partners, we would be making that deficiency good in the profit sharing ratio. So looking at the example here, if you see, ABC are equal partners, A guaranteed, that is contribution in profits will not be less than 7,000, but he would contribute only 4,000. So what we will be doing is, to 15,000 he would be adding 3,000 rupees of deficit from A, making this total to 18,000. Now this 18,000 will be distributed to all the partners equally, which comes to 6,000 each. And then C was guaranteed a minimum profit of 10,000. So there is a deficiency of 4,000 rupees. There is a deficiency of 4,000 rupees because C was guaranteed 10,000, whereas he is getting only 6,000 rupees. So this deficiency of 4,000 would be made good by A and B in the agreed ratio, which is equal in this given question. So that would be again 2,000 each. So the final sharing profits for A would be 4,000, B would be 4,000, C would be 10,000. So these are the four different situations wherein the questions related to guarantee of profits, it could be from the firm side to the partner or partner side to the firm, can be solved. So these are the basic things, and if we are clear with these things, our next video would show you the different questions which are unsolved questions given in the same book which we are following, the T.S. Grewal ones, edition 2020. So hope you have understood these fundamentals of guarantee of a profit. If not, request you to rewind this, go through that logic, note down all the important points, so that whenever we do the unsolved questions, you will be ready with your concepts. Thank you so much.